Hello, Nose. Here they are again. Matrixer. With Shiva and Jonathan. Many of you are already familiar with the phenomenon of astral travel, the out-of-body experience. And then we might not be the first to talk about it with the video here with our explanations. But we can only say that we may have one or the other hint or one or the other piece of information for you that you don't know yet. And then maybe you can get a bigger overview. Also in connection with our previous videos about the matrix, about the light trap and the like. And then you can perhaps see the connection much better, how it all correlates with each other. Now I would say let's move on to the next point. Why is it so hard to remember an astral projection even though we do it every night? Well, we astral travel every night and whether we remember it or not is totally independent of that. For this reason, meditation is a way to ensure these nightly journeys are remembered. Perhaps we should say beforehand why one remembers so seldom or so badly. And that too is somehow related to the matrix. Yes, for the astral body is for the electronic double of the physical body. And it has its very own frequency, which is influenced by the creators of the matrix. And the intermediate area was also created by the matrix makers. And then when you want to get from the physical body to the intermediate realm, then you feel the vibrations and these electrical phenomena. One hears strange electrical sounds or hears some other acoustic phenomena. And they are all related to the fact that there is a kind of installation in the intermediate area that tries to erase the memory as soon as you come back from the astral to the physical body. And it's the same with dreams. There are similar effects taking place there. And these vibrations and these electrical phenomena also come from this oblivion machine, so to speak, you could say, right? Yes. And so when you feel these vibrations or also these electrical phenomena, this can be very energetic, but energetically one can also describe it as electronic in this context. As electricity. And so we're back to electric shocks. It's the electric body. Yes. And these electric shocks are administered to erase the memory of the astral experiences. Right. That's the same as trying to exit the Earth matrix. You'll get electric shocks too. Correctly. And those electric shocks make you forget about it. These experiences that you had. And usually one forgets, to put it better. Because there are of course ways to salvage memories from the state. On the one hand, you can program yourself on it and download them, the memories. But it's not all that simple. This can also be done with hypnosis, for example. Auto-suggestion. What other options are there? Yes. Actually only techniques on the subject of out-of-body experience. Either through meditation, nocturnal meditation or through so-called consciousness games, which one can play in everyday life. But the techniques we'll do later, right? Yes, we will do the techniques later so that you have something to practice in order to be able to reach this state yourself. Exactly. Now we come first to the stages of detachment. So the stages of detachment look like this. First of all, relax your body. Logic. And as soon as the body is very well relaxed, you move on to the next phase. And that's when it starts to have to reach the first milestone. That means the body has to fall asleep without you. Normally, everyone falls asleep as soon as the body goes into standby mode. That's when most people fall asleep or snap their memories of that stage. So the art is to achieve a state where one stays awake while the body sleeps under a path. Exactly. To achieve the state. I practiced that at the time by taking a key and hanging it over the bed. And I lay down and tried to stay conscious, to dissociate, so not to think. And at some point you drift away and then the key falls off and you're awake again. A good trick. That's exactly what you do again and again, until the limit keeps shifting back. I ended up lying awake for hours, I don't know, with my body asleep. Yes, that's good technique. That you use there, in any case. Another technique is to pull your legs up so they are so straight, keep your legs in the bed and your knees together, and as soon as you nod off, your legs unfold. It's good technique too. Ah, okay, and then you wake up from this movement of your legs, which then just folds apart. And then you know again, oh crap, I just fell asleep or I have to continue. These are little tricks to get into this state, in which the body then falls asleep and one remains mentally awake. Of course, what is important is the will to stay awake and to set the goal. I don't fall asleep, I'm awake. Consciousness is awake. The body sleeps. And as soon as the body falls asleep, you notice that too. Then a slight heat wave comes through the body. It starts with the feet and goes up to the head. It's such a mild heat wave. You feel that, in which you suddenly get warmer. Then please don't cover it. Because then you're out again. And when you've done that, that is, the body is asleep and you're still mentally clear about it, then you can move on to the next phase. It's much easier to get to from there. So the difficult thing is actually that the body falls asleep and you stay mentally awake. This state is quite difficult to achieve. It takes practice, training, and once you've achieved that, there comes a point where the vibrations come up. And the noises. And the noises. And of course, the oblivion machine is already trying to electrocute you so that you forget everything else. So the energy that is being released comes from this electrical frequency that is trying to drive your oblivion again, or that you switch off with me. But if you manage to keep it clear, then the vibrations will eventually become so strong that they will peak. And if you are still clear about it, then you can switch to the astral body. This can happen very suddenly. It suddenly clicks in my head. Or you have the feeling that you are sinking down once, briefly, and then it is already in the astral body. And when you've done that, you just roll out of bed. Roll to the side, that you land on the carpet. Or my favorite technique is just floating up or dropping. Drop through the bed. That works too. Drop down through the bed so you can get away from your body a bit. Of course, that's the next thing that matters. That's building distance to a body. Well, I always roll to the side and then straighten up when I'm lying on the carpet. I tried the technique for a really long time, but never worked, because I always moved my physical body with it. Yes, of course that is a small problem. But float, letting go is easy for me. Float. Yeah, and when you are out of the body, he first tries to build up some distance to his body. He calmly goes to the bedroom door, or goes into the hallway, or goes into the living room. Just take a few steps away from the physical body. And, of course, make sure that you stay clear about it. You can also practice, for example, you can practice rolling. For example, in your normal everyday state, when you are awake, you can put a mattress next to the bed and practice rolling out of your body. Just let yourself fall onto the mattress. Do this a few times to get a feel for it. You'll get the feeling right away. Also, very important. So the astral body responds to falling feelings. Some of you may know this from your childhood, that you dreamed that you fell down somewhere and then you slammed into your body. And the feeling of falling appeals to the astral body and facilitates the transition from the physical to the astral body. Suggestions. Also very important that every night when you go to bed and turn off the light, you say to yourself, I'm having a conscious out-of-body experience tonight, and I remember every detail. And that should be the last thought you fall asleep with. Always repeat like a mantra, tonight I'm having a conscious out-of-body experience. Always repeat, like a mantra, until you fall asleep. Or even get into the state where you can detach yourself from your body. We're almost at the techniques, aren't we? Yes, yes. Yes, we are actually already at the techniques. Yeah, forgot to mention, but it's okay. Yes, let's start from the beginning. List the techniques. Sure. Well, the WBTB, wake back. Technology, where you then lie down in the evening, around 10 p.m. It is best to sleep about 4.5 hours, because then the body is already rested. Then be awake for half an hour. Of course, it would be best if you were awake in the dark and walked around a bit, so that melatonin production does not stop and serotonin is released. And when we go back to bed after half an hour, you do the suggestion again and concentrate on the techniques. But that's pretty well known. Yes, so 10 p.m. to bed. Alarm clock rings at 2:30 in the morning. You stand up. It's best to leave the light out. You can move a bit in space or do something in space. The best thing to do is to deal with out-of-body experience a bit, get in the mood for it. Or you can even simulate as if you are moving your astral body. You can walk across the room and pretend, I am looking astrally at the hands and in the body in order to simulate the condition a bit or to simulate it. To address, you can practice rolling with the mattress. So you can do all those things in that half hour. And at 3 o'clock, you go back to bed. At 3 o'clock, then you could meditate again. For example, that you imagine us doing skydiving or bungee jumping or something similar. Anything to do with traps. That helps a lot. And always focus on that. Until then, these vibrations appear. And if you're lucky, you even jump above the vibrations and suddenly you're in the astral body. If you can't fall asleep after half an hour, you simply go down a long flight of stairs and with every step you go deeper and deeper and deeper into relaxation. Yes, and then when you have managed to be out of the body you can explore the astral planes or the intermediate area and you can then decide to fly somewhere. Maybe you want to visit someone. Or maybe you want to visit any sites. Eiffel Tower, pyramids, Stonehenge, whatever you can think of. Another technique to activate the astral body is by trying to play with your limbs. The limbs is still quite easy to feel as the astral body and that you are trying to take your hands or your feet. It's pretty easy. You can do that in everyday life too. I can feel it now too. I could give you my astral hand now and you can see it in the dark, the energy. If you swipe back and forth, and in the light you can see it too. It's just you trying to play with your astral body and feel it, move it back and forth. Yes, and if you move them back and forth, you could sometimes see a trail that is then drawn. So slightly bluish, there is a trail behind it. Similar to cigarette smoke, so I would say the color. Such a slightly blue haze that you trail behind. And there you can move your hand again and try to see this energy trace. So all this serves to make you a little more familiar with your astral body. And then you can also, if you are in bed and want to go astral, you can try to raise your vibrational frequency. It's actually a very simple command. Namely, increase in the astral body with vibration frequency. Actually works almost always and you feel an inner tingling. It also works. You then practically already feel the astral body. That's how I started back then. Because I started to increase the vibration frequency and then at some point you start to vibrate more easily and then more and more. And then you focused on the vibration and that they're getting stronger. Like a swing boat. For example, moving back and forth with the astral body. Yes, one thinks of the fair. You know that swing boat? This huge swing boat with so many people sitting in it, swinging back and forth. You imagine you're in this swing boat that's just rocking back and forth. Or to the sides. Or you imagine lying on a waterbed. And that's exactly what's possible. Or you imagine you are on a boat. So there are many ways to address astral body levels. It is always important to sway, fall and fly. All those feelings, the astral body feels addressed and then the change is a little easier. If you are good at lucid dreaming, you can of course also change super astral. And that's what I've always done by just falling backwards when I'm lucid. Just let it fall and bang, I was astral. Yes, that's a good method. As soon as you manage to become lucid in a dream, I always did that. For example, I stood on a chair and spread my arms and let myself fall backwards off the chair. It is important in a lucid dream to be able to switch directly to the astral body. That two factors are given, i.e., case, feeling and threat element. In my example, that means the feeling of falling by letting myself fall backwards. And the sense of threat is there to address the astral body. And that is generated by letting yourself fall backwards off your chair. You wouldn't do that in everyday life, because then you could hurt yourself. Even on the street when you're out there in a lucid dream. I always stood on a curb and then let myself fall backwards onto the street. Feeling of falling and threat from the road. Could a car come? Exactly one car. And these two components support a shift into the astral body. Yes, and then we come to the last topic, I would say. Namely blockade. Okay. Why can't we trigger an out-of-body experience? Usually there are fears behind the blockages. Just like me back then. Fear of the dark. Fear of being attacked by some demons. It can also be simply fear of survival, right? Yes, the body thinks naturally when trying to shift into the astral body. That's it now. Then you would have to die. Because the body thinks, oops. How is it so far? Do we have to die now? And then of course he gets scared. The life support instinct is activated and the result is fear. So fear is mandatory. That's not your fear. It's just the survival instinct that's being activated. And you have to live through it two or three times. This fear. And then it disappears afterwards with the further detachments. You can still say that the fear comes from the ego and basically doesn't exist, it's just a construct, but of course it wants to keep you from going astral. because you could discover something different and important on the out-of-body experience. That's the way it, because on the out-of-body experiences you can convince yourself of what levels there are and which realities you can visit and what conditions you experience there and the like. And the more frequently one travels astrally, the greater overview one gets. Another way to conquer the fears that don't exist is to feel them completely. That is, you feel the fear, you feel it fully, but you are detached. You know it's not actually your fear and you feel it through until it's completely used up. Exactly, it's like you bite into it and eat it until the bread is empty. These fears then go away over time, and no matter how strong the fear becomes, it may also be that the fear or your ego then says you are dying, you will die if you continue. Do you understand? Stop. Excellent. When you have come this far, you are very close to detaching yourself from a physical body. Because the fear is already beginning to reach its highest point. Because the only thing that fears, actually fears, is dying. And that is what one does when one changes into the astral body. You die at least a symbolic death. Then just to get to the astral plane. That is, with your will. You have to say, I don't care even if I die. I want out of body experience now, I'm changing now. Correct. Your will must be stronger than your fear. That is the point. What other blockages are there? And the fears? And of course alcohol. Oh, so typical. Are such typical blockages. Not good either. Of course, if you go to bed drunk, out-of-body experience doesn't go so well. Marijuana is also not conducive to out-of-body experience. Or for dreaming in general. That was beneficial for the waking state to be able to have experiences, which are of course also important. But for the nocturnal experiences, marijuana is not so recommended. What else causes problem? The ones you have in, for example, there is an additional payment that you have to make. 1,000 euros should you pay back, heating costs or something. Of course, these are also thoughts that may occupy you and then discourage you from practicing out-of-body experience. First you have to solve the everyday problem and then try to switch to the astral body. Yes, that was it with the topic of out-of-body experience. Was a very interesting topic. And we hope that one or the other of you will manage an out-of-body experience. Of course there is much more to say about it and maybe we will make a video with more information at some point. Let's see how interested you are. What questions do you have? Yes, whatever questions you have. You can post the questions in the comments below. And we always look forward to your questions. And we hope you enjoyed the video. And we also try to answer the questions regularly. They don't always do it the same way, but we strive to. Yes, then thanks for watching. And have a nice day. Have a nice day and see you next video. Ciao.